just look at discrete probability, and basically again looking at discrete and first a few of the definitions included for you as well, then binomial, then Poisson. So again, just when we look at a discrete, and you guys have now seen in the quiz and maybe already in your assignments that there's things that they love you to work out, like the mean and the variance, sometimes the standard deviation, but they also throw in a bit of the definitions. So remember, this is for discrete probability, these two. Then when we go to binomial, what we might get is something like the formula. We saw in the quiz that they ask the formula for Poisson distribution. So it might be in your assignment, binomial might come up, but it will always be just for the probability of X equal to. They will not ask you to use the formula to work out 6 or 7 probabilities. And then just the other thing is how we work out the mean and the variance with binomial distribution. And then the last slide, and I will also again share all of this, the Poisson distribution. We have used this formula in one of the quizzes to work out what was asked, but again also just look at the mean, that is the lambda, but also the importance of the lambda is equal to the variance and is equal to the mean. Okay, so sometimes they ask you a question where they give you lambda and they ask you what is the variance, or they might ask you what is the standard deviation, and it is actually hidden in the question because it is very similar. So the things that we need to know about the discrete is how to, apart from how to read the probabilities, is to be able to work out the mean and the variance of a discrete distribution. The same with binomial. Need to know if we get the binomial distribution or the formula to use, that we will be able to use it for one of the one probability to work out. Then the mean and the variance, very important. And then the same with Poisson. Know the formula if I ask you to, like in the quiz, that you need to use it once. And then the others is just that the lambda is equal to the variance, is equal to the mean. What I will also show you is, again, just how we will use the tables. So when we get to those questions, I'll copy the table in, that we can also look at the table, because sometimes they want to catch you out with the table, and they normally give you that options to catch you out in the option set as well. So we will go through the tables as we go through some of the exercises. Okay, so let's get into some of the exercises. So the first one, they ask us basically, we've got a number of pizzas delivered to university students each month. It's a random variable with a following distribution. Okay, so the first thing we see is there is one without a probability. So first thing we know from probabilities is that all these probabilities need to add to one. Okay, so we can work out what is that missing probability, and that is 1 minus 0.2 minus 0.3 minus 0.1, which gives us 0.4. So that we can work out by saying all of that probabilities needs to equal to 1. So if we need to get that one, we say 1 minus that minus that minus that, and we get that the probability of x2 is 0.4. Okay, so which one is incorrect? So probability of x2 0.4 is correct, so we actually have worked it out so that we can answer the first one already. Okay, so let's look at the others, but there I want to bring in some of the different colors. So probability of x small or equal to 2. And probability of x bigger than 0. Okay, so we're looking at that probability. X small or equal to 2, x bigger or equal to 0. So that will be 0.1 plus 0.3 plus 0.4, which is 0.8. Okay, so that will be correct. So let's look at the next one. Probability x smaller than 3. Okay, so we're not including 3. And probability bigger than 1. So we're not including 1. So we're only looking at x is 2. And there we know it is 0.4. So that one is correct as well. And then let's just look at the last one, and then I'll take a question. X bigger than 1. So x bigger than 1, not including 1, is basically 2 and 3. So it's 0.4 plus 0.2, which is 0.6, which is also correct. Yes, there's a hand.
Good morning. Good morning, Mr. Chum.
Morning.
I've been doing the assignment, time assignment too, and I noticed that the questions that they ask, they often trick us. They even trick us more than what and the examples that they show us. So my question is, how would we know that they are asking for us to calculate that using the Poisson distribution or the binomial distribution? Because I think I failed in most of the questions when they bring up a scenario and then they hide it away which one you must use, and then I often kept on failing it. So at least if I know how I can do that, and also what the variance and the sensitivity, the thing, can you please show us examples of that? Because I think I made a mess there in the assignment, and it cost a lot of marks there. So at least okay. It can help me and other students.
Okay, cool. That's 100%. So as we go through the questions, I will identify for you guys when it is binomial or Poisson, because that is critical. Because if they ask you binomial and you use Poisson, and then you use maybe four vivariants, also the wrong one. So we will definitely, as we go through some of the questions, I'll show you why it is binomial and Poisson. Okay, so for, and I think the first one with this one, why it's discrete is because they talk about a random variable. Okay, so the reason why this one is discrete is they talk about a random variable where the number of pizzas are delivered. So it's not about where binomial is, yes, it gets delivered or it does not get delivered. So that is already the big difference, is that when you look at binomial, is going to be event is going to happen or not. So this one is basically talking about pizzas being delivered randomly, and what's the probability that students get 0 pizzas, 1, 2, or 3 pizzas. Okay, so that is how you need to see this one. So that's why it's random discrete variable. Okay, so if you look, so then you can just read off the table the probabilities. So now if you need to do for the discrete, the mean, even though we know this one is wrong, the mean for the discrete is basically x times your probability of x, and you need to sum all of that. So normally how I would do it is to say, okay, 0 times, because that's for x, times 0.1, that gives me 0. 1 times 0.3 gives me 0.3. So I will need to add all of them together. 2 times 0.4 is 0.8. And 3 times 0.2 is 0.6. And so if we sum all of them together, we will get the mean, which is 0.3, 0.8 plus 0.6. So that would have been 1.7. Okay, so the mean is 1.7. It is not 0.7, so that is why option 5 is the wrong one. Okay, so when we get to the others, I will also just indicate, just by first reading it, what we're dealing with, and then we can go into the detail. Okay, so a lot of times with the discrete random, they will tell you. So discrete random variable, and nearly it is always about, so how many pizzas did the students buy? So is it 0, 1, 2, 3, 4? In this instance, how many cars do people own? Is it 0, 1, 2, 3, 4? So it's nearly every time when we look at the discrete random variable, it is nearly going back to that study unit 1 that we looked at, and we always said a discrete variable, it's the number of, or the count of. So that is nearly where it now comes in with the probabilities. So it is that count of. So if, again, if we were in this session and we said, okay, there's 28 people in the session, what's the probability that you will have zero cars? It's 0.25. What's the probability that in this room there's people with one car? 0.4. Two cars, 0.2, and three cars, 0.15. So this is nearly how you always need to look at the discrete random, because that is nearly always a summary of what's the probability of you owning, buying, a number of things. Okay, so and with this one, they just were looking at different probabilities. But what's going to be interesting is, yes, we're looking at different probabilities, but some of them might give you the same answer. So let's look probability of X bigger than one. So it's not one. Bigger than one is zero and two. Okay, so bigger than one is zero. Bigger than one is two and three. So that is 0.2 plus 0.15, which is 0.35. So that is correct. Okay, so let's look at the next one. Probability X smaller or equal to 2. So smaller or equal to 2. Basically 2, 1, and 0. So 0.2 plus that is 0.6 plus that is 0.85, which is correct. And so let's look at the next one. Smaller or equal to 2, so it includes 2, bigger or equal to 1. Okay, so bigger or equal to 1, smaller or equal to 2, 0.4 plus 0.2, 0.6. Okay, so at the moment, all of them correct. X smaller than 1, well, smaller than 1 is only 0, so that is 0.25, which is correct. And then let's just look at the last one. We now know that one is incorrect. So we know that is incorrect, but let's quickly check. So X smaller or equal to 1, but bigger than 0. So it's actually only looking at 1, and that should be 0.4 and not 0.65. Again, if we included 0, then it would have been equal to 0.65, but then the formula should have read X smaller or equal to 1, bigger or equal to 0. Okay, so I normally like to use the coloring, because that just visually makes it easier to see what you need to add, what you need to not look at, and things like that. Okay, so let's look at the next one. So analyze the frequency of which cross-country skiers participate in their sport. The sports created the following probability distribution: X, where it's a number of times per year. So again, they didn't tell us we deal with a discrete distribution or random discrete probability, but they said X is the number of times. So again, we know from study unit one, number of, so you can only go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 or zero. You can't have a number that is 1.5 times per year. How do you go a half time? So again, nearly the things that we've learned in study unit one now comes out here by remembering, okay, discrete, number of, or count of. So number of times tells me it's a discrete probability that we need to deal with. And then a lot of probabilities and a mean that we will need to work out. So let's look at the first one. Now suddenly they ask us which one is correct. Okay, so again, one needs to switch that on, because if you look at the first one, probability x equal to 3, probability x equal to 3, 0.21, not 0. So if we read it as incorrect, we probably in the exam would have said incorrect and gone on to the next question without realizing we're actually looking for the correct one. So just be careful. They don't ask a lot of the times the correct one, but when they do, they normally, the first one is an incorrect answer, because your mind is just programmed nearly to every time look for the incorrect one. Okay, let's look at x bigger or equal to 5. That is bigger or equal to 5. So it is all of them. So it is 0.12 plus 0.08 plus 0.06 plus 0.05, which is 0.31, which makes that one wrong again. So I think what is important here is, if you only said bigger than 5, then you would have gotten the 0.19. So if you said 6, 7, and 8, you would have gotten that number. So again, normally it is not that far off the answers. Okay, so let's look at the third one. X bigger than 5 and equal, so 5 and equal, smaller or equal to 7. Okay, so we're sitting with those two. So it's 0.12 plus 0.08 plus 0.06, which gives us 0.26. So that is why that one is also wrong. Again, if you only said 6 and 7, you would have gotten the 0.14. Okay, so just be always careful on what they are asking and what you're looking at. Okay, so let's look at the last one of the probabilities. Smaller or equal to 3. And so it includes all of them. 0.04 plus 0.09 plus 0.19. So if you only set up until that point, you would have gotten the 0.32. But because we need to add 0.3 as well, we get that is 0.53. Okay, so that is also wrong. So the one that is correct is the mean, but let's quickly work that out again. So 0 times that is 0. 1 times that is 0,09. Plus 2 times that is 0,38. Plus 3 times that is 0,63, I think. At some point, I'm going to run out of direct space, but that's fine. 4 times that is 0,64. 0,6. Point 0.08 times 6 is plus 0,48 plus 0,42 plus the last one 0.4. So hopefully that now all adds up to 3,64. So 0.09 plus 0.38 plus 0.63 plus 0.64 plus 0.6 plus 0.48 plus 0.42 plus 0.4 gives us that sum is equal to 3,64, and which is that answer. So option 5 is correct. Okay, so that is how we look at the discrete probabilities. Again, this one they didn't tell us, but they told us we're looking at the number of times, which should be an indication of looking at discrete probability. And so let's go into the next one. So sometimes they do tell us it's binomial, but if they did not tell us binomial, they need to, and we'll get to other questions now where I will show you why it's binomial. But all these, we also remember in Poisson, we look at lambda binomial is where we look at this sign. So just also there's sometimes the signs that can give it away. So for this one, N4, the pi is 0,2, and we need to look for x smaller than 2. So let's bring, I just want to get my binomial table. So I want to copy it in that we can just look at it. So let's make it a bit bigger. Cool. Okay, so let's again, N4, pi 0.2. So again, I would just when I work with it, do this so that I don't get confused when I need to look at it, when I know at least I'm only looking at that component. So I would, again, you guys have the tables on in your books, and also it was also part of this, what is it, that letter 101. So you have that. Okay, so we're looking at that component. They told us that n for pi, and we're looking x smaller than 2. Okay, so x smaller than 2 is just x 0 and 1. Okay, so it's only those first two. It's not looking at including 2. It's only looking at those first two. So it is 0.4096 plus 0.4096, which if you add those two together, so if we add those two together, we get the answer of 0.8192. Okay, just again, careful. If you only set x is equal to 2, there is the answer. Okay, so again, just sometimes be very careful. If you set x bigger than 2, and you added those two together, there is the answer. Okay, so again, careful when you guys answer it, because there might be just things that I want to again catch you out. Okay, so that is the first one on binomial. This one they told us, we're doing binomial, the next two will not always be that clear. Okay, so here they actually again told us, let's just see, in the Limpopo province, about 50% of adults have 4-year college degrees. Okay, so the important thing again are to identify if it is binomial or not. So they're not asking us or giving us a table of what is the number of college degrees that each person have. So here it is, do you have a 4-year college degree? Yes, 50% have, 70% don't have. Okay, so again, that's why binomial, the event happens or event does not happen. Okay, so we don't have in this instance, we're not asking how many college degrees, the spread of that, or we're just asking, does the people have it or don't have it? Okay, so a yes or no answer. So then they say, suppose 5 adults at random are selected. Okay, so 5 at random are selected. Calculate the expected value and the standard deviation of this binomial distribution. Okay, so we've got n is 5, the pi or p or whatever you want to call it is 0.3. So we need to work out standard deviation and expected value. So the easiest one for binomial expected is n times. That say it is 5 times 0.3, which is 1.5. Okay, so expected value mean 1.5. Okay, that's correct. Not correct. That's correct. Not correct. Not correct. Okay, so if you needed to guess because you don't know how to work out the standard deviation, at least you have only two options to need to worry. Okay, so standard deviation. So first, the variance is in B, so that's, remember, the mean. Let's just rewrite it, sorry. Okay, so that will be your variance formula. So if you work out that, it will be the 1.5 times, so let's just write this out, times 0.3, then 1 minus 0.3. So if you work the variance out, it is 0.15. 1.05, sorry, not 0.15, 1.05, but that is variance. We want standard deviation, so the square root of variance is what we're looking for. So it is the square root of 1.05, and that is equal to 1.025, which is option 3. Okay, so very important nearly to look at these two, and the reason why they love to ask this, because again, it's not big calculations that you need to do, including the standard deviation. It's not big calculations, but you need to know how to do it. So it's not that you now needed to get out Excel and work out with huge formulas. It is actually, in a sense, very simple calculations, but again, it is those things that they want to catch you out, because again, we program to work out nearly the variance because that's the formula that we have, and then there's an answer for that variance. So they want to nearly catch you out, that at that point you say, option 1, tick, let's go to the next one. So again, just be careful with these ones, because yes, it's not that difficult, but there's always nearly a catch in it. And that makes it difficult, because it is nearly, but again, if this was exam and I did this, I probably would have stopped at the 1.05, because I got my answer of it, the first one, and would have forgotten, but that is actually variance, not my standard deviation, and I still need to go on. So just be very careful when you're doing this, that that you don't make that mistake. Okay, so let's look at another one, and let's look at what they tell us. Okay, according to a report from the Center of Studying Health Systems, 20% of South Africans delay or go without medical care. Okay, 20% without, so 80% have medical care. So that is nearly how we can identify it as a binomial. 20 goes or don't, 80 goes. So again, they didn't tell us now this is binomial, but they nearly told us again, if 20 goes, the other don't, or vice versa. So according to a report from the Center for Studying Health Change, 20% of South Africans delay or go without medical care because of concerns about cost. Suppose 6 individuals are randomly selected. Let's write it here at the top, then we can bring in a table if needed. The probability that more than 4 will go without. So the probability of X more than 4. Okay, so not 4, because more than 4, so it is 5 and more. So let's just again look at a table. So N equal to 6. So we can actually take this table. Oh man. So we can take this table. We have N is 6. Probability we've got again as 20. And then the probability that X is bigger than 4. So let's just, so not 4. Okay, so it's basically the last 2. Sure. Okay, so we're looking at 0,0015 plus 0,0001. So we are looking at basically those two numbers, because probability bigger than 4, so we're only looking at 5 and 6. So if we add those to 0,0015 plus that, we get to probability that it will be 0,0016. Okay, so that is nearly how we would again look at this one. They talk about something happening or something not happening, so that is the indication of binomial. And then they give us the information of 6, and yes, I normally would have loved that they say 6 like that, so that we can just nearly pick it up. But they talk about the 6, N is 6, and then probability more than 4. Okay, so let's go into the next one. That's weird. Why can't I? Okay, so next one, they talk number of accidents per week. So when you see the per week component or the a time component, then we're working with Poisson. Okay, so when there is a time component to the question, we are working with Poisson distribution. So they might say per day, per hour, per week, per month, per year. So when we get the time component added to the question, then we are dealing with a Poisson distribution. They gave us the mean, so we know that, remember, the lambda is equal to the mean, so the lambda is 3.5. So again, we will go to the Poisson distribution table where we look at 3.5. So let's quickly just copy that in. Okay, so we have lambda 3.5.
So if I can just quickly ask, is this the question 2 from the workbook?
Yes, it is.
Okay, thank you.
Yes, it is. From, I think, study unit 5 in the workbook is divided into, there's a few questions on discrete, then there's a few questions on binomial, and then this is the part of the Poisson. So it's that question 2 of a workbook that's focusing on the Poisson distribution.
Thank you, sir.
Cool. Okay, so 3.5, and then let's quickly see what they ask. The probability of no accidents. Okay, no accidents means x equal to 0. No accidents, x equal to 0, 0.0302. Okay, so they also want to catch you out now to say 0. Because if you looked at this, and the last one is 0, so definitely not that. Then the other ones, if you just made a slight error by looking at it a bit skew, or you're say to yourself it's 0.302, then suddenly there's also an answer for you. So just be, because you won't see that 0.30 anywhere else, so just be very careful again. So it's just that when you read it, and you might just read it quickly and you just look at the 302 and then you pick it wrong. So just be, especially when you guys are, the assignment is different because you get more time in the assignment. The exam is where things get a bit rushed. And then sometimes one make a mistake because of a rush in the exam. Okay, so let's look at the next one, question 5. So random variable Poisson distribution with 3.8, and when they ask us probability of y small or equal to 5. So let's just see if 3.8 is on this one, then I can bring it to this side so that we can look at 3.8. And now we're looking at smaller or equal to 5. So let's check where's 5. And smaller or equal to 5. So it's all of them. Okay, so remember, it's including 5 and smaller. So what they normally would do in your answer set is probability of 5, there is 1. Okay, so it's not that one. What they then normally would do is around the 5, they might ask if answers as well. So if you looked at smaller than or equal 5 and you said, oh, but where is 0.1944? Okay, so just be careful when, again, you look at it, that around that 0.5 or probability of 5, they sometimes will give you options as well. So for this one, unfortunately, we'll need to add all of them. So I'll start at the 0.02, so 0.0224 plus 0.085 plus 0.1615 plus 0.2046 plus 0.1944 plus 0.1477, which gives me, I hope I'm right, 0.8156. Okay, very easy. One can again make mistakes with the adding. So when you do it, also just, I would nearly do it a few times just to add and see that I'm getting the right answer, because again, might be that one make somewhere a mistake and then you sit with a 0.83 as well. So again, just be careful when you add all of them together. Okay, so again, important thing nearly for this one also to see what you need to include, what you need to add up. And that is normally also where most of the time I want to catch you out is more around the numbers than really the other things that they give you. Okay, the last one. So let's look at this info. Tomatoes for January in Kansas follow a Poisson distribution. But again, if we haven't had that wording, an average of 3.2 per month. Okay, so that would have been the 3.2 per month. Let's just, so we can actually use this one table again. And every time we're using just a different one on this. So this one we will use the 3.2. Okay, the probability that in the next January, Kansas will experience exactly 2 tomatoes. Okay, this one actually quite nice. Exactly 2. So exactly 2 is 0.2087. Now just again, look at, there is 1.304. So if you read that one a bit wrong, There is one for you. If you looked at 3.2 and you said free tomatoes, there is an answer for you. If you've added 0.0408 plus 0.134 plus 2087, 0.0408 plus 0.134 plus 0.2087. Luckily, there wasn't an answer. But luckily, if you added those three together, you didn't get an answer, which at least is good. Then if you set 1 minus 0.2087, that would have been an answer as well. So again, just be very careful when you work with the tables that, and again, you guys have, so prepare now already nearly for the exam that those tables that you have, even the ones in the study guide or your tut book, rather get that printed. You are allowed to use PDFs on your laptop or on devices, but it is just easier again if you use a ruler to get that, because again, if I look just a bit skewed, there is another one for me. So nearly a tip for you guys, when it's not that essential now, because yes, the assignments are a big component of it, but in the exam, the pressure is just so much more. So I think, and you guys can correct me, but I think you guys are now writing the assignments you're getting 3 hours time, or is it not timed at the moment? So I think
it's 2 hours.
Sorry?
It's 2 hours.
Okay, so there's 10 or 13 questions for 2 hours. Okay, so what is going to happen in the exam, it is nearly going to be double those questions for 2.5 hours. Okay, so in the exam, it does become a bit more pressure on you when you are doing it. So if you guys can get some of these tables printed beforehand for when you write in October for the final exam, then it normally does help a bit, just so that one can read some of these things right off and not just, because if you just make that simple mistake, one can easily choose one of the other answers. Okay, so that is it for chapter 5, everyone. I'm gonna put everything, will be on WhatsApp in the next hour or so. I will put the presentation.